On Monday morning, EverGrande Group, China's second-largest property development group, will likely find itself unable to make the interest payments on a series of loans to China's banks and will technically likely default, with trading in many of its onshore bonds already suspended. With September being a seasonally choppy period in markets and the echo of the Lehman collapse, September 2008, audible, many will extrapolate the failure of Evergrande and talk of a coming market collapse, with contagion rippling across the banking sector. I am not so sure about this, just yet. This approach may also see the arrest and denunciation of its executives, the restructuring of the company, though no state bailout, and the injection of liquidity into the financial system. China is unique amongst major economies in that it has plenty of scope to stimulate its economy. What will be far more interesting and instructive than chatter about a Lehman moment, is the insights the collapse of Evergrande will give us into the principles and durability of the China that Xi Jinping is trying to build.